So how many of you would say that you're really familiar with the Common Core State Standards? Nobody dares to raise their hand? Susanna? No?
Really?
All right. Does anyone feel that they're somewhat familiar with the Common Core States? Okay. All right. And anyone a little bit? Okay. Or not at all? It's okay. You can. All right. Well, we hope to change that because they are going to become part of our lives as adult educators. You know, I think we've spent a lot of our years avoiding K-12 and distinguishing ourselves from them, and now we're kind of put in a situation where we're getting more aligned and integrated than we ever expected. So that's a good thing, though, I think, as far as the articulation that, you know, to higher ed and careers, so it's important. All right, so content standards have been around for the last 5-6 years, and as many of you know, CASAS was asked by the National Consortium to develop content standards for reading, math, and listening, and we have some for writing and speaking as well that are on the web already. So we did do that, and you've been using them, I know, for many years. But with the advent of these Common Core State Standards, we have aligned our standards with those standards. And those Common Core State Standards are what you could call national academic standards. Now, they were not originated by the federal government. They came out through the National Governors Association and the Council of Chief State School Officers. So it was a state-led initiative that brought them into being. Because they all felt a need for this kind of national standards effort. The college and career readiness standards were created in September of 2009, so that there was the impetus for college and career purposes. And then after that, the Common Core State Standards were developed, and those detail out the standards at the different grade levels. So what are they? They are intended to provide guideposts, just like any other set of standards, for what students at each grade should know. But they are national, and so far 46 states have adopted them. They have been developed in English language arts, so that's reading, writing, speaking, and listening, as well as what is called language in K-12. They're also in literacy, in context of history, social studies, and technical subjects. These are, in adult ed terms, these are our competency contexts. There are mathematics standards, and the science ones are in development and are scheduled to be released this December. There's a lot of new acronyms for us to learn, and one of them is CCR. College and Career Readiness. Okay, so, and they do just that. They talk about the path to colleges, to post-secondary, that is college, careers, any kind of work, and as well as informed citizenship. Now, the College and Career Readiness Standards, the CCRs, are the anchor standards for, next acronym, the CCSS, the Common Core State Standards. So they do provide the framework. The CCR, College and Career Readiness Standards, the CCR standards provide, they are throughout the Common Core State Standards, and they do serve an organizing function. So if you have to get familiar with something, become familiar with those anchor standards at least, and then the Common Core State Standards get more detailed at the grade-specific level. There was a lot of research that went into development of the Common Core Standards, and they do provide a lot of information about what should be taught and learned at each grade level. You know, I hesitate to say grade level, we've avoided it for so long, but it is now part of our world. But we are going, you know, part of our challenge, I would say, is to interpret it and make it our own for adult ed. And that's where we, I think, have a creative contribution to make to all of this, is, you know, we're to look at it critically and say, okay, the basis is there, the research is underlying is there for the skill areas, reading, math, but to then apply it in contexts that are relevant for adults is still extremely important and something we're not going to lose. But they do provide a consistent set of standards across the country, and as I said, 46 states and DC have adopted it, so this is not something that's going away. This is something quite tangible and real. So they are aligned with college and work expectations. That's been one of the main goals, is to create that bridge to college and career. They're clear, understandable, and consistent. They are really very well written. They have rigorous content and application of knowledge. A lot more higher order thinking skills are included to get more academic rigor within them. They, you know, come at a time when many of us have worked on standards for quite a while, so they, I think, have benefited from that work that we've done over the past 5-6 years and incorporated some of the lessons learned. And they are evidence-based. So, you know, in a way, all of that work has been done for us. The research has been done, and here is a set of standards that we can, I think, use with confidence. All right, so what have we done about it? We have aligned our reading content standards to the Common Core State Standards. We had the help of Questar, a nationally known measurement organization. The math standards actually are, not will be, but are aligned also to the Common Core State Standards. And we have a document that we'll be showing you in the work groups that contains these alignments. Our NEDP has also been aligned with and is really being developed based on the Common Core State Standards when it's relevant for what's being measured in the NEDP, which is pretty much most of it. So there's a very strong relationship of the Common Core to the NEDP. And so if you would like to see, our own content standards are not going away. They are still on our website, they're still being used in your programs, there's still reports in TOPS and TOPS Enterprise. So we are now in a transition phase, still using the reading, listening, math content standards, but trying now, I think it makes sense for you to begin to think about how to see how they align to the Common Core and start to bring more of the Common Core into it if that's a direction that your state or program is moving in. But the thing is that we are moving in that direction, so we hope that you will too, at least to the extent that that's how our new test series is being designed, based on the Common Core, but still, as with the Common Core, taking into account all of the lessons and understandings that we have learned over the years from our own reading standards. So if you want to see our CASAS standards, they're on the website. The reading, math, and listening have been around for some time. We just recently posted the speaking and writing ones. If you'd like to take advantage of those, they're there.